Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new, welcome. I'm Meg and I wanted to talk to you guys about my experience buying secondhand makeup from the Facebook page that I belong to. Now, if you are in Australia, there is actually a Facebook page called Buy and Sell High-End Makeup. I'm gonna link that down below. Now, it's a group that you join. Okay, and it's where I buy my secondhand or pre-loved makeup. Now, I'm very particular with what I buy as a secondhand, and I don't buy any creams or liquid products secondhand. It's always just powder products, okay? Because there's less likelihood of bacteria contamination, and I can always disinfect it. Whereas with creams and liquids, especially, never lipstick or mascara or stuff like that. Never. Okay. Anyways, I wanted to share my experience there because I have sold a few things in there from my collection when I decluttered and also bought a few things. I've sold some of my Urban Decay palettes, my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blush palette, the one that came in threes. I think I've sold a NARS palette as well, a few eye palettes from Zoeva. What else have I sold? Oh, I've sold my Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette as well. So there are a few things that I've sold on that website, but there are also some things that I've bought. Now, obviously, with the Facebook group, there are certain rules to it, and I would always tell you guys that to make sure that if you're paying for a product, make sure that you pay via PayPal. Do not choose the option family or friends. Always choose goods and services so that if you get scammed, which is not impossible with the internet nowadays, is you can still at least get your money back, okay? I would never do bank transfers directly because that's just dodgy as hell. So anyways, so I've bought a few things there. The first thing that I bought, which I also don't have anymore, is the Violet Voss Metal Palette. I forget what it's actually called, but it's like the metallic palette that had, I believe it was 20 shades. I did buy that and she sold it to me. It was untouched and I could really see that it wasn't even swatched. So I bought that for, I believe it was $40 when I bought it plus shipping. And I've sold it because at that time I wasn't really into the colors anymore. Now I kind of regret selling it because now I think I should have kept it. But anyway, I don't have it anymore. I sold it for the same price that I bought it. And I probably use it maybe once or twice. Or I think I may have sold it for like $30. And the lady came to pick it up, so I didn't have to charge for shipping. I always do transactions with PayPal, even when whether I'm selling or buying, okay? It's just safer. Even if I have to like cough up a little bit of PayPal fees, I just feel it's a lot safer to do it because you never know. People are just mean sometimes, okay? Then the next thing that I bought from there were these Makeup Forever eyeshadow palettes, nine eyeshadow palettes. This one is Volume 2, which is the more colorful one of the two. And I have really enjoyed using this. And this one is the Volume 1, which is the more neutral shades. Now, unfortunately, these ones are, they're not matte. Some of them are satin, so you can actually use them as a crease color or transition shades, but they're all kind of shimmery. These two were like, they were sold to me for, if I'm not mistaken, because these here in Australia is $68 at Sephora. And they, I remember they were on sale at Sephora at the time, Sephora US for $25. I got this for $40 each, so $80, but she also included shipping into that. So I paid $80 in total for this two, which is pretty good because they were untouched. They were brand new, still in the box, never even swatched. That's what I always usually go for. It's either it's been swatched but never used or never used at all. So these came in their respective boxes with everything that is usually the paper that comes with it. So I've been loving these, really using them quite a bit. The next thing that I bought, I've been dilly-dallying, Is that even a word that is used nowadays? But yeah, I've been dilly-dallying about purchasing the Vizier palettes because I've been burned before. I bought the Royal Bijou or Bijou Royale palette and I was not happy with it. I was like, what are people talking about? With Viseart eyeshadows, they're like all over it, but now that I own one, I'm not really that impressed with it. So I had sold that one as well on the website for a good price. Actually, I sold it for the price that I bought it, because I bought it at IMAT, so it was heavily discounted, and then I sold it for that same price plus shipping. So there you go. But I've always been looking at the Viseart palettes, but none of the 12 pan palettes really interested me, but some of the theory palettes did. So those are the 6 pan palettes. And then I saw these being sold, and these are the Viseart. This one is Nuance, and this is the Amethyst one. The Nuance one is the more pinky of the two. So that's what it looks like. I still have that packaging on it. Now this came to me swatched, but the only thing that was swatched was this one right here at the top. Okay, and you could probably even tell that it's swatched. You'll see it there. I have already used it, so some of these are like brush strokes really, but this one you can see really that it was swatched. I haven't used that shade at all, but all the other shades were untouched. Okay, so that was pretty good. I was pretty happy with that when that came. It was packaged pretty well as well. I want to thank Amy for that. The Amethyst one is the more purple one. Now, this one was not even swatched. Now, the use that you're seeing there is me using it with my brushes. But this one was not even touched. It was brand new. Wasn't even swatched at all. So, pretty happy with that as well. And she sold these for $25 Australian each. These are $45, which in Australia is something along the lines of 60, I believe. About $55-$60, and I bought these two for $50 plus shipping, which cost me something like $8.50, but I paid her $60 because one of these is going to be equivalent to $60, but I got two for the price of one. So very, very happy with that as well. And it was like, one, it was bubble wrapped, shipped very, very well, and it was clearly unused. Okay, the next two are products that I have been thinking about purchasing for a while. I was even thinking about going into Mecca Cosmetica and just shelling out the 60 something odd dollars that this particular powder is worth here in Australia. In the US, I believe this is something like $46 for one. And this is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder, and this is in the shade Radiant Light. Okay. Now, this came in swatched as well. I can see there was like one swipe on the powder, but everything else was like, you can't even tell that it was swatched anymore. Right, I do have the dim light one, but that's a little bit too bright, too light. So I use the dim light one actually underneath my eyes, and in the center of my face as sort of like a highlight. But this one is the one that I use for all over my face, because it's much more my shade, and I can see that. But it's like pretty much my skin color. So it's a finishing powder that I use, and it gives me that beautiful glow on my skin, especially when I'm using matte foundation. It just gives me that beautiful glow. The other one from the same seller, this is from Gemma. I got the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Edit, and this is the first one. Now, if you remember watching me talk about this before, I passed on this, even though I really wanted it, because I had 3 of the shades that were in here before, from my dim light one. Okay, so I've got the dim light here, but also the 2 blushes. I had them in my ambient blush palette, okay, which I sold and regretted selling. Actually, I regretted selling that. So when I saw that she was selling this for $80, She sold me this ambient, this radiant light for $40. This is something like $65, $66 here at Mecca, brand new. This was just swatched once. Now this one doesn't even look like it was used. There's a nick on the luminous flush blush right here, but other than that, everything was pristine. And it was $80. This is $116 here in Australia. Okay, so she sold this for $80. This one was sold for $40. So I essentially, so the $36 and something like another $26 that I saved from these two, I paid for shipping, but then she actually lives close by, so she just delivered it. And I didn't ask for the shipping money back because like she drove all the way, like a 30-minute drive to give this to me on the day that I ordered it. So it was pretty cool as well. And she was really nice. Gemma was really, really nice. So really, really good quality unused products. I have been in love with these, especially the radiant one, because it just really gives me that beautiful glowy skin. And in fact, these two were my favorite shades. This is Mood Exposure and Luminous Flush. Those were my favorite shades from my blush palette before. And now I also have the Luminous Bronze Light, which is a beautiful bronzer and just perfect for my skin tone. There's Diffused Light right here. Oh, sorry, Diffused Light right here. Okay, so this is the bronzer, this is Diffused Light, which I don't have, and it's like the lightest one, which I use as a highlighter. Iridescent Light is in the center, which I believe was a limited edition to this one. I don't know if they've already released that as a single as well. I know they are tiny, but honestly, I don't use that much powder anyway, so these are lovely. And I have been enjoying the way these women are actually like sharing the love, I would say, because some of these are like things that I would not be able to purchase at their original prices, but because they've been kept in really good condition and some of them have not even been touched, I'm pretty happy to pay those prices. I have had one instance where I was trying to buy that blush palette from NARS, the dual intensity blush palette, and I had already paid $60 for it, but the girl kept on saying, oh, sorry, I got busy at work, so I couldn't send it. And I was like already leaving for my wedding in 3 days, and she still hadn't sent it. So I'm like, can we just cancel the transaction, send me back my money? Because honestly, I can't wait for this. I'm going to be away for a couple of weeks, and I don't want it to be sitting outside in my mailbox or in the post office while I'm away. And it was just like, it wasn't a nasty thing, but it's just that she was a little bit difficult to get hold of and doesn't really respond very well. A lot of the people that I've spoken to and have had transactions with in the group have been pretty pretty good. And also with me, when I tell you that I'm going to ship to you the product on that day, I will ship it, you know. And I expect the same kind of courtesy to the people that I buy from, because like, sometimes I don't go for lunch so that I can go to the post office and ship it out, you know. Or I would come to work early so that I can leave earlier and make it to the post office before it closes so that I can ship it out to you. Or I would come in a little bit later to work and also stay back so that I can make up for the time that I used to go to the post office. So because I do that, I also expect the same kind of courtesy and the same kind of, you know, commitment from those people that I transact with and I buy from. So yeah, but that was the only instance that I've had that kind of issue. A lot, like for instance, this Viseart one, April even went as far as shipping it express to make sure that it gets to me, because she said that she was going to send it out on Monday, but she wasn't able to. So on the Tuesday, she sent it to me express the following day, coming from Tasmania. It's a different state. So, and then it came to me the very next day. So I was very, very happy with that. So very, very thankful to the women who I've done business with, whether I've sold my makeup to you or you've sold your makeup to me. Thank you very much for being such great business partners. Having said that, like I said, I'm going to link down the Facebook group if you are in Australia. It's a great group to be in, but you have to also be respectful of the rules in that group. And please don't be scammers, please. I just wanted to share that experience with you guys. I have no issues with buying pre-loved makeup as long as they're in good condition and that they are powders. I would never buy creams or liquids. Like foundation or lipsticks or mascara. Maybe foundation as long as it comes with a pump, but it's a little bit difficult unless you actually know your shade. So, yeah, that's my thing. If you haven't already, please do subscribe. If you're in Australia, I hope you subscribe because I do a lot of contents that are Australia-related. In terms of makeup, I mean. So, yeah, subscribe. And hit that notification button if you want to be updated on when I upload my videos, which is usually Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. That's it. Bye.